went back to Montclair and faced the problem of making ends meet. We scrimped and cut corners with one purpose in mind, to keep the family together.
There you are.
Thanks, Albert.
Thank you, Doctor. Come in again. If you don't mind, I think my spaghetti are ready. I'll take my lunch while the business is slow.
Well, you go ahead, Albert. Enjoy.
Thank you, Doctor.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Where's the other barber?
Oh, he just went out to lunch.
Oh.
Is there anything I can do for you?
Well, I had hoped to talk to Albert because I... Dan, Fred! Stop it right now. Because we've been coming here for so many years and he knows us so well.
Whatever Albert can do for you, I'd be glad to do. And more.
Well, these are my brothers and sisters.
All of them?
No, there are four more. And since we're such a large family and we need so many haircuts a month, don't you think we ought to get a special rate?
I think you should get a medal. I mean, large families are the backbone of the nation.
That's not the point. The point is, do you think you can give us a special prize?
Well, that's a lot of hair. How do I know these are really your brothers and sisters? How do I know you just didn't collect them on the street and you're getting a rebate from their mothers and fathers?
Well, I never. Why, everyone in Montclair knows the Gilbert family.
Gilbert? How do you spell that?
Come out!
B-R-E-T-H.
Mm-hmm. First name?
I don't need a haircut.
Yes, I noticed that. You look fine. You should always wear it that way.
You don't sound like a barber to me.
Ah, Miss Gilbert. Glad to see you back. You still here, Dr. Grayson?
Doctor? Are you a doctor?
Don't feel bad, Miss Gilbert. I'm usually taken for a busboy or a street cleaner. Do you think a mustache would help?
No.
Neither do I. Goodbye, Gilbert.
Bye!
Well. Oh, Dan.